by the winter of discontent, and Maggie's tipped to be heading for number 10 as the whole country lurches to the right. But over in Southall, an event was about to take place which would change race relations in this country forever.
This was a breaking point. Either we had to defend the community, otherwise, you know, the whole community would have just collapsed.
Hard though it may be for anyone under the age of 25 to believe, but the late 70s was a tough place to be British and Asian. Racism was commonplace, and the community had none of its current confidence.
For most white people, Asians were seen as being quiet, being quite tolerant, basically taking anything you gave them. They were essentially seen as victims, I think. They were definitely seen like that in the popular media as well.
The sergeant made us awake, you shut up! He's awake.
Where's my tea?
Yes, Sergeant Major Saab. And don't forget, Sergeant Major Saab, that you only have 6 minutes to perform your absolutions.
There was some myth that Asians, young Asians and old Asians, were docile. You could kick them around. You can't say that about a community that had an experience of chasing the British out of India.
Southall in particular had a South Asian population since the 50s and was now known as Little India. It was home to one of the most visible ethnic minority communities in the country. But with the racist murder of a young Sikh in 1976, there was a growing sense of anger in the area.
We'd witnessed the first ever racial murder in Southall. A young Asian guy called Gurdeep Singh Chagga had been murdered.
I mean, I remember seeing his coffee and thinking, you know, with a couple of my friends, you know what, we might be next.
So young, old, white, black, men, women within that area galvanized and began to organize.
Anybody who was around there and abouts of the early months of 1979 would know that there was something gestating in the Asian communities up and down this country.
The final straw came on April the 23rd, St. George's Day no less, when in the run-up to the general election of 79, the National Front decided to hold an election meeting in Southall Town Hall, seen by the local residents as an act of blatant provocation.
For the National Front to hold their apparently legitimate election meeting in an area like Southall was a well-calculated assault. Our initial reaction of disbelief and amazement quickly turned into anger. Our priority lay not allowing the meeting to take place.
There was an air of expectancy, but nobody knew what would happen.
This was a breaking point. Either we had to defend the community, otherwise, you know, the whole community would have just collapsed.
The National Front had begun to become respectable, gain electoral prestige and successes throughout the country. Everybody saw that danger. So apart from a few community leaders, or so-called community leaders, a large section of the population were part of that mobilization.
We knew that the National Front were going to have a meeting at the town hall. We also knew that the whole police presence was going to cordon the whole section of that road off. But we were determined to break the cordon down. We were determined to sort of, in a way, we believed that we could actually go through and actually go into and disrupt and actually stop the whole meeting.
We realized that the National Front were being marched in, only about 30 of them, who none of them lived in Southall, were being escorted by the police to come and have a public meeting within Southall.
The police presence was just formidable, and what I remember was that we went through the police cordon, we broke through the police cordon, we went through, and then suddenly we just, out of the blue, were witnessing a whole barrage of horses that were, you know, were just charging towards us.
And then what followed was what I would categorize an orgy of violence, where the riot squads came in and whoever was in front of them was beaten.
Police and thieves in the street. With
We fled into the park, and you know, people were just running for survival. They were being battered. But luckily, people reorganized themselves. They knew the alleyways, they knew the roads, and they were able to sort of come back and make another attempt. The whole town was a war zone.
In the aftermath, it became clear that 345 people had been arrested, countless members of the public injured, and one teacher, Blair Peach, tragically killed. But long term, the positive effects are still being felt far beyond Southall.
The 70s were just a turning point in British history, in the sense that you had, for the first time, Asians actually believing that they were going to make an impact into British society.
People are coming to defend a town which they value, and they don't want racist or fascist kind of politics or actions to dominate. And I think it always be remembered as an important historical day when Southall actually grew up, despite the orgy of violence it experienced.
Southall opened the doors for another generation now to discover themselves without being too concerned about prejudices. When you see young Asians walking the streets and so on now, sometimes I wonder if they know that those who are now in their probably 50s or so had led a charge.